straight line job, but it's physically demanding.
Physical input to riding those things.
Yeah.
So
this Christmas tree just all like starting to peel in.
struggle with most.
You have to explain to people, you know. Sometimes you can't explain it quick enough as you're driving around.
Yeah, there's so many bits
to stop, yeah.
Right, curve.
Just so now, well, Ginger Hall's all right. Once you get into the Kerrymuir section, it's so technical. It takes a long time to know what you're doing and to have confidence there. Right, so from now on, just
put
the wagon
to the motor. So this is like a double apex, you went for the telegraph pole there, it says, yeah, so I'll come back into this.
Straight line, yeah, I used to drag
it off
there, right across to the very green bit there, see that?
Alright, yeah. So
you're going over a little jump,
yeah.
But by doing it that way, your bike is upright going over it, rather than trying to change direction, which can be unsettling. That's another one. Well, but just after the same, isn't it? When you straight line as well.
Yeah, yeah, straight on the way out of there. Just going to pick the bike because you're dead straight.
See, this is not too bad, but this right hand goes on forever. I always wait until I got to the opposite the gable end of this house.
Yeah.
Then I go in, otherwise you could be going in too early and having to have another crack at it.
Yeah.
Just swing like this. Let this wagon go ahead.
Section, just get it back through the gearbox. Really, I could almost sort of like start to accelerate once I've got back over this little hump.
That's exactly the same treatment as the first one. From the left, crossing the road and coming out on the right side.
Get the corner done early, get it up right.
But I'll tell you what, I used to love this section. Once you knew what you were doing on those two bits, it's very satisfying.
Yeah, you're getting it right.
The feeling, yeah. Tight there and then cross the road to the right side again.
Fantastic. Yeah, up straight for that.
Yeah. See, this is the bumpiest part of the course, but who knows, next year this could be billion times smooth. You know,
can't allow a lot of speed to this place if they do that. You might short shift through here just to well, your eyes will start shaking and everything.
It's rough, isn't it?
Yeah.
Hello? Adrian, hiya. I gave you the tingle before because I only had a couple of newcomers go around on this bus. I was going to see if you were going to come with us, but I couldn't get you, so we had to go. That's alright. I couldn't hang around because we've got to get this lap done because we're all out tonight to practice. But I'll give you a ring on the week whenever I get a chance. And if you can come, you can come. If you can't, well, we'll just try it the next time. You're welcome, Sonny. All right, see you later, boy. Ta-da. Ta-da.
Steve, I've got a lot of trees down there as well.
Oh, God, yeah. You see, this used to be different years ago. They had different white lines in the road years ago. And then when you got to these ones, they were longer white lines. Because of this work step,
right.
And I used to say to the guys at that time, once you see the long white lines, that bit is flat, there's nothing there, you see. It's only because of all these wagons coming in now from this work step. Because on the bike at race speeds, all that section flows that much quicker than going in the car. You'd think you'd ever get to the end of it in a car like that.
It's nice, a little tight, it's not just like rolling back here.
A lot going on here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Changing down, banked over, braking.
Trying to give yourself plenty of time.
Okay, so right opposite those two chevrons, there's a telecom grate on the pavement, which is your apex where you want to be tightened. See it there?
Yeah.
Right down there. Newcomer said to me last year he got a bit confused at this point, but I stopped just by this hall, and you can look back and see those chevrons, and you look on, and you can pretty much see where you're going into the first.
Same again,
curve.
There's a lot going on, but it's very straight line. You've just got a straight line. curb, hedge. It all does this round, you can't see, you just pick a line and go straight through
it. This is hard riding out here, you know, it's very fast and it's poopy as well.
This curb tries to jump out at you, so same again, as long as you're in the centre of the road, no worries, it'll just jump out and disappear.
You got your marshals sitting there with the high vis on.
I was using that miling feeling.
Two big trees on the back with ivy on them. The second tree. And then back to the left side, the loop from where all the cottage comes into view. See there now?
Yeah, I was trying to get this as a late apex.
Dive under the hedge.
Yeah, missed that curve and the jumps out.
If you get it right, it's just a flick beside that kind of thing.
Right.
Quite happy with May Hill.
It's just bumpy, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just bumpy. Just.
Do you want to have a look at it? Or
you can do. I was using the apex, and then you drift out and don't use that side of the road. Do you stay away from the bumps? Yeah.
Exactly.
And a little wheelie on the way out. It's like a little hump.
It's always somebody unfortunately gets it wrong, big time. The thing is, when you look at it, if you've never seen it before, you'd understand why people get it wrong there. If you were a typical English short circuit scratcher,
and use that right,
you'd think,
use the racing line.
Yeah, chuck the bike on its side, get your knee on the deck, and hug the right hand all the way around. But I mean, the bike will throw you, just tie in a knot and chuck you off. Well, the other thing is, of course, it tightens as you go around, so you can just run out of space.
Yeah.